how many watermelons does it take to stop a crossbow bolt? So we got about, 9 watermelons set up right here, as you can see. And we're gonna shoot it with the bat reverse and the mega bat with field points and broadheads. And we're gonna see how many watermelons it takes to do this. So I know I already said that, but now that we have more watermelons, we can resume this challenge. Let's go. All right, so first up, we got the bat reverse. How many watermelons does it take to stop the bat reverse? Gonna load the bolt up. Let's go check it out. Okay, so it went through 3 all the way and then it went under the 4th one. So we're gonna do that again. It seems like it gets pretty deflected pretty well. Oop. Let's take another shot. I'm gonna aim a little higher because it seems like the bolts go way down. Bat reverse versus watermelon. Okay, round 3. So far it's been going through 3 of them and then stopping at the 4th one. Let's try one more time. I'm gonna aim a little at a different angle. Okay. Okay. So yeah, it stops right at number 3 or 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. Okay, same results. I'm gonna leave that bolt in there and we're gonna take the mega bat up against it. If you guys haven't seen this mega bat, this thing is awesome. Let me cock it for y'all. This is super cool how to cock it. Check this out. So step on it, just like that. So cocked and loaded, or just cocked. Now if you load it, we just slide this sucker in. Now we're cocked and loaded. I think this might go through all 9 watermelons. Okay, I don't even know what I'm looking at. All I see is a water, like a massive green thing. Okay, 3, 2, 1. Okay, this is gonna be cool. Guess how many watermelons it took to stop the bat, the mega bat. I can tell you right now, it didn't make it all the way through, but let's go check it out. I'm gonna grab you golfies for this one. This one's gonna be exciting. Glad we're still recording. Okay. So, oh man, we see it right there. Started going through this guy. Look at this. Look at this watermelon juice. Oh, they're bleeding. They're bleeding. Okay, so 1, 2, 3, 4. It hit the 5th. Started going into the 5th. Just, oh my gosh, this is so bad. Oh, we need to figure something out. Well, we lost 2 more watermelons because they rolled off. Dang, that's kind of bad. So the mega bat only went through 1, 2, 3, 4 watermelons completely, and the bat reverse went through 3 completely. So not that far behind. Pretty impressive on the pistol crossbow part. Thought that the mega bat would do a little better, but now let's throw on the broadheads. Now this, I'm gonna throw an annihilator broadheads on, and I'm really curious to see what that's gonna look like. So we can see right here, they're stopping right here at number, this is number 5. With the broadhead, it might go way further, or because there's more surface area, it might actually go less deep. So let's find out. Sweet, so I wanna show you guys this so you guys can see. We got the mega bat, we got the pistol crossbow, and the mega bat went through it, right? This is the 4th one completely. The pistol crossbow hit it, but didn't go. But as we can see by strength, the mega bat is only going 1 full watermelon deeper than the pistol crossbow, which is pretty impressive on the pistol crossbow. That's telling you how strong the bat reverse is. Like, this thing is packs a punch. But we're gonna throw on the annihilator broadheads and pull these out. Oh wow, look at that. Completely shot through the vein right there. Okay. Tasted the metal part, bud. Didn't get any juice. There's no juice in there. This one's kind of dry. Maybe the Annihilator will shake it up a bit. Let's put it on. I'm gonna put these back on. Now, my fear is though, these watermelons just start sliding. So what I'm gonna do, I'm gonna cram it in there and I'm gonna tighten, kind of, there we go. This ain't going nowhere. Okay. I'm gonna go grab the broadheads. I'll be back. So shooting the Annihilator broadheads right here. Check that out. This thing looks sick. But gonna take these field points off. Put these sucker back on. And comment down below right now what you think, how far it'll go with the broadhead. So my guess is if it went through 4, I think it'll go through 5 with the mega bat and with the pistol crossbow. I think it's still gonna be hitting the fourth one. I don't think there's enough energy to punch through. However, we'll see. Plus I know like there is more surface area, so it, I feel like it can parachute and catch. But I mean, look at that. That looks epic. Okay. Just look how deadly that looks. That looks insane. Are you ready? Take it off safety. Woo! That sounded really good. Okay. Let's go. Let's go, let's go, let's go. Okay. As you can see, we're getting some really good drippage right now. Even more. Just bizarre drippage. Okay, I see it. Dang, it stopped right in the third one, right there. It's a nice wound though, if you ask me. See, and it's right in here. I'll probably pull it out just so I don't screw up the broadhead when I'm shooting it with the mega bat. Let's dissect it real quick. So definitely getting some nice exit wound right there. Just rolled away. Slide this sucker out. Look at that, just a complete hole right there. And right in the third one, right there, right in the third one. Let's pull this guy out. Ooh. So it takes 3 watermelons to stop the bat reverse with the broadhead, and takes 4 of them to stop it without a broadhead. And I think that's just because the broadhead slows down a lot, because obviously it's a lot bigger. But obviously the wound is a lot bigger. So 3 watermelons, that's about, I don't know, 3 watermelons. That's about the size of a, that's wider than a deer. So definitely we'll get a pass through on a deer, and it's been proven, it's been done. But you can see that's about the size of a deer. Let's put the watermelons back up and see what the damage is with the mega bat. Just like that. All my crossbows are gonna be sticky now. Look at that, folks. Tell me that don't look deadly. It's probably gonna be, so if the bat reverse went through 3 only this time, didn't even hit the fourth, I'm gonna guess this one's just gonna go through 3, but it's gonna stop in the fourth one, just like it did with the field point. Dang. The drippage, listen to this. So she's bleeding real good, as you can see. But, do y'all see it? Right here, so 1, 2, 3, 4. But the thing is, it went down and hit that bore down there. So we're gonna pull that out and shoot maybe a little higher, see if we can get it to go further, but not touching this one back here at all. But let's see if it goes any further, or if it maxes out at 4 for watermelons. With me. One watermelon all the way through. Two watermelon all the way through. Three watermelon, not all the way through. I pulled the bolt out just a little bit already by pulling that. That one's gonna be good. Okay, so I pulled the bolt a bit. Okay, this is important data. I'm gonna put it back just a little bit to where it was before I pulled it out. Okay, just like that. So this is the fourth watermelon, right here. As you can see, we didn't need to go to the store and buy any more watermelons because it only takes four watermelons to stop the Megabat. But I'm curious, because we have watermelons, I have a bow and it's only at 65 pounds right now. I definitely want to crank it up. I just need to do that ASAP. But let's take a shot with the bow and see how many watermelons it takes to stop a bow, just out of curiosity. But there you go, folks. Four watermelons and three watermelons for the Bat Reverse. So the Bat Reverse isn't that far behind than the Megabat, which is pretty impressive considering that the Megabat is a very powerful crossbow. But that just shows you how powerful the pistol crossbow is. I don't know if I'm even in frame half the time. Sorry about this, folks. But let's go grab the bat. I'm gonna wash my hands, kind of clean back up and grab the bow, and just out of curiosity, shoot through these watermelons and see how far it goes. Now, a lot of these watermelons already got holes all over them, so don't really know. Don't even know how to aim because I'm so close right now. Gonna put this up all the way. So I think I just gotta aim high, right? Just gotta aim high. I'll just aim at the bottom of my arrow. Holy moly! Well, I completely missed. Dang, that's bad. That's really, really bad. That is like really, really, really bad. Wow. Wow. So this is not good. Luckily, I have a very safe background, but so I thought, you see the knock right there, right? I think that's a wrap for the video, folks. Now, I didn't see it hit the grass anywhere, so it probably flew over and it's somewhere over there. But luckily, so there's just a hill back there. There's no houses back there or anything, but pretty sketchy. Sheesh. Anyways, stay safe, folks. Leave a like if you enjoyed this video, and I'll see you next time.